Okay, Friday stream, and here we are with Pokemon Shining Pearl as we sort of begin the wrap-up of bits. So yeah, we're back at the Pokemon League at the moment. Good. So we're going to head back out this way. Because obviously apart from the island on the northeast side, there is also a little bit down here that now opens up. There's also a Susie here, kinda.
Hi. I'm playing the Rings of Elders.
Couldn't wait until Monday.
Neither could Alex.
I know. I've already sent my disappointment to Alex. Maybe I shouldn't have let Alex borrow my PS5 controller. I guess Susie just dead stopped like,
I know, I've got an item that made me go, ooh.
So yeah, we can now go in here. Steelix. Right, so first things first. Defog. Right. Get another one of these escort bits. It denies us being able to surf.
Why offer me then? Jesus.
Hey, it's one of the Dirt Brigade. Double cutting on their attack stat, that's gonna hurt them. Let's tag in. Kind of looking forward to next month for one reason.
Where's that?
There's nothing coming out.
Yeah.
Just a nice day. It was a nice month for money. So he be such a nice time to have a month again without anything major coming out. There's no games I want coming out next month. There's no I think there's no I'm gonna double check. Releases. Yeah, nothing in March at all. Though it's then back to releases in April. Advanced Wars.
Alright.
At least you had just one game for April, at least.
I have a fair run for... I want to say a couple of months.
Yeah, that'll take you to wait for a couple of months. And then end of May would be the next thing with Forspoken, so... I mean Game aren't listing it, so I think that's just going to be eShop.
So then it's going to be, yeah, the next game is going to be Xenoblade 3 though.
What about Splatoon?
When's Splatoon coming out?
They said it was going to be, like before summer. So yeah, given that, we are looking maybe like June time, potentially.
Well, Splatoon 2 came out in July 2017.
June, July. Because remember, the way they've seemingly lined it up, because they did say Xenoblade for September, and they, I think they just said summer for... I think it was actually summer they said for... for Splatoon, but... they're not going to want to put it out in September when Xenoblade's coming, so it's going to be before then. So, which, you know, Splatoon's a good game to kick out just before summer.
It is, especially because all the kids are going to be coming out soon.
Yeah, exactly. Because, I mean, Fire Emblem Warriors is out in June, but I don't, that's not really going to catch people as much as Splatoon does. Though Mario Strikers is also in the beginning of June.
Yeah.
That's the only other thing, because, you know, the people do like the Mario football games. But...
enough of them.
So, yeah. But I'm saying, yeah, it's going to be the pre-summer holiday game. Be coming out around all that time, so
good. Everything is still brittle as everything. Right. Love Dark Souls physics.
I'm going to go. Fair enough. Though I do have a PC game coming out in... I think it's also in May. So...
What's coming out for PC?
Chaos Gate comes out.
Yes.
I believe that was when it was.
God, I think I found one of the swamps.
Jesus Christ, why did I have to? Check on this. Yeah, 5th of May it comes out. Couple of extra things with the game. Pre-ordered, just get a couple of the campaign items early.
Yeah.
And then there's the Champion Edition, which gives you the soundtrack and also an early unlock of a pretty major Grey Knight named character for the campaign. Noting these unlocks do not affect multiplayer, so it's not, you know, pay to win for the pre-order and the special edition when it comes to the multiplayer, which is nice that they're declaring that. XCOM 40K.
Living hell is this? Oh god, I just stopped this butthole! What the hell?
Susie is paying for her insolence. Susie liked it.
Did something in the distance just turn invisible? I think something in the distance.
Susie liked whatever happened.
I hated it. I hated every second of it.
Nope, Susie liked it. Because it involved misery and pain. And Susie likes people being in misery and pain. Which is sad for me.
I don't like your misery.
Then go find Poppy. Because it's misery and pain until Poppy comes. Oh geez, not the abomination. Do you remember what you gave Pops for dinner?
No, I don't.
Susie. Susie needs to treat Poppy with better care.
I keep stabbing these things buttholes.
How many kitties does it take for Susie to be like, I will have all the kitty hugs right now and not do anything else?
A lot.
Well, you better start getting those cats.
I need cats first.
Well, I said go get them! Poppy's probably just waiting for you. Just being like, woman, look at what I did. I'm cat. She's just there waiting for you to come and give her a brush. Because that's what a good little kitty wants. I hate this bit when they give you a strength thing and then it's... Oh, you only get one of the two items. Did it in the original games and it's here as well. Sucks. Ooh, who showed up? Boo.
What the hell?
Boo that no cat showed up.
This is probably not gonna end well for me.
For double intimidate to make certain they don't basically have no attack stat from the get you. sounds like Suzy's home. Hi, Captain.
No.
Well, someone just sent out Captain Derpy.
Good.
Always respect the captain. Even when you have to beat him to the ground. Do that, buddy. Cause that's gonna help when I'm freaking asleep. I thought the game rules prevented multiple Pokemon being asleep. Point 5 out of 10 needs more cats. Fuzzy.
Yeah.
Needs more kitty.
I'll let you know when kitty comes.
No, Fuzzy goes get the kitty. Kitty will then be on your bed and be like, "Hi, woman. I get to sleep here now. I am a happy cat. Also, woman, where is box? I am cat. I must play with box. Box, woman, where is it? Boxes are always adorable.
What
Anything else going on in the news?
Enter Evergal. Yeah, alright, why not?
You made me confused. Of course, then it can hurt someone to fool you. Yeah, I can get off the ground then. That thing is, it's like a top rose. Go away, Holmes Crow. Disappoint Susie. Do it, game.
I'm disappointed. Oh, Jesus Christ, you hit hard! You're not one. Did not ask.
And now on long to do this. Down to you two. get you on X, we'll take you out. By the chin, for sure. Hemorrhomit. Excuse me. Okay. go, so... Reasonable to go out and come back in. This. There we go. That being a quick tech grab. So I'm just checking something. So I have to live it down here. Yeah, there's nothing in the news really. Yeah. Come on, game. Take these on. Ding, Not all of them. Sozy. Unless Sozy's gone to get pops. Be happy. Just a good key. Need hugs. And a lot of fuss. She needs one. Take a gastrodon first so they don't want one less trainer to deal with. What's the best thing to do when you're double fight? Make certain you get one Pokemon down. One set of Pokemon down. Healed on Nom. Taking us basically an hour to get through this cave. Jeez. I didn't think it was that long. Oh. Maybe it just shows that we're in an extra week, maybe? I don't know, maybe we're actually prepared to next week. I don't know. We'll see. Hold on. There is one new Pokemon Baron down here. No war.
I'm back.
Ah, so yes, that totally was BRP'd.
Sorry.
Just gonna adjust Pokemon in the team for a moment. With a key.
She brought herself upstairs.
Aww. Hi, Pops. So he's not gonna tell her I'm saying hi.
Oh, sorry, she's in the window.
She really doesn't want to tell Pops and saying hello. So is he being mean?
I'm not telling her. She's not with me. I'll say with me, I mean, she's not with me.
Here's our new Pokemon. Got a Lapras. The wave. Hey Pops!
Except my blood.
What?
This is just something I'm following in this game.
Oh, I thought you were saying that Poppy wants to suck it. I was like, what? Why would Poppy want to do that?
I'll be worried if that was the case.
I mean, she might be like, give me your blood, human, because I want to just make a mess, but... Didn't think vampire cats existed.
I mean, not yet.
Get in the ball, Lapras. No, I said in the ball, not break out of it instantly.
Get out the ball!
TA, you lurking around. We're gonna need you, I think. How do you like your Lapras cooked?
Salty.
What?
Salty, right? I think that's how you pronounce it.
I don't even know what you're trying to say.
Like salted mushrooms.
Oh. I wouldn't know because I obviously can't have mushrooms, so.
I know what I'm trying to say, I just can't voice it. blimey, hello.
Susie's having a midlife crisis.
I am, I'm having a load of midlife crises right now.
Crises. Yep, TA, can you come and have a word with this Lapras, please? Because I think it's going to need some stabby warnings.
Oh god, a rat! Hello!
I assume in the game, not in your room.
Yeah.
Because I'll be like, Poppy, get it!
I would be screaming.
Hey, we caught the Lapras. Let me just update them all. So they got weekend plans?
No.
Okay.
Mostly sleeping.
And giving Poppy a brush.
Yep.
Hear that, Pop? She's gonna get a brush! You looking forward to having a brush, Pops?
She doesn't look too happy right now.
Oh, what's wrong?
Just Poppy being Pops.
Better give her a fuss. Just cheer her up. Is he?
Huh?
I was like, give her a fuss.
It's a scratch.
Hmm?
Give her a bit of a scratch.
Uh-huh. Do you like it?
I hope so.
No, your cousins should be in her home.
That as well.
Oh, man. Why is everything so dull and boring at the minute?
Because.
Yeah, I mean, there's a very good reason, and I'm not going to say a word on it.
Yeah.
Because everything got delayed because of a stupid pandemic. I mean, that is the other thing too, but you know, the first thing is also the other thing.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, Elden Ring has voice chat.
Pardon?
Elden Ring has voice chat options.
Well, that's definitely being turned off.
I totally agree.
It's the last thing we need. It's what everyone uses Discord for. And then it's also DLC fodder that they could do later. If they want. Although, knowing Miyazaki, it's gonna be another swamp.
I mean, I've already come across, I think, one swamp.
I think he said there's three. In the preview talks. Or at least three, something like that. You know, it either is three or at least three. What did a swamp do to him that made him want to have everyone else suffer?
Backstory, he died in a swamp. Oh no, sorry. His parents died in a swamp when he was a kid.
Yeesh.
It's not real.
I know, but geez, Susie.
Hey, it's a good theory. Game, no. I actually hate that channel.
Yeet yourself out the window.
Yeah.
Susie just does the comedy thing where she grabs the back of her top, the back of the collar of her top and just drags herself out.
Yeah.
And then we just have Poppy watching just like, what?
Oh, I found the chest, I think.
Woman, what are you doing? Woman, why are you being so weird? Woman doesn't wear a collar. Why does woman grab something that isn't there? Also, I have Belle. Razor core. Thank you.
models seem beautiful.
Hmm?
The blood in this game is beautiful.
Typical you.
What?
There's no typical you'd fall in with that.
It honestly is beautiful.
No. So he's not in that job anymore. Yep.
Are you kidding me? You're finished?
I'm not finished!
I mean, this trap following me.
He wants to be your friend.
Well, why don't you be my friend? I'm so crampy about it.
Susie, be nice to it or you're being a bit of a pinch. Susie clearly is feeling a little crusty.
Ground super effective steel, but rock doesn't.
Yep. Because steel is super effective against rock. Well, if you technically think about it, then, you know, the steel is, you know, used to cut rock. So... They made, you know, they've worked around it in some form, in some sense to it. And how you doing, Joe? Just Susie.
Just me.
And Susie's playing on a nice, shiny, new 7-year-old PS4. Well, bear in mind, ground covers more than just rock, so... Like I said, there's probably some key, like, lore, like, reasoning to it, because obviously, consider, like, how they run, like, the elemental tables and whatnot in Asia, like, metal being its own bit has different... Yeah, exactly, so that could be one way of viewing it on top of, like I said, how they... have the different views around these sort of like elemental things in Asia. So,
yep.
But obviously, but yeah, obviously, some of them, obviously, they just do for balance reasons. So.
Yeah, how you up to a good Joe?
Not a bad combination. Yes, I am not going to go into that because I remember last time.
Back here. Ah, click on the wrong things.
Get yourself pizza with coffee. Yeah. What sort of pizza? Your life now flashing before your eyes.
Yeah, most likely. Oh, soft cross. Okay.
Yeah. It's funny, when watching through one of Linkara's stream from a couple of weeks ago, they had a huge argument about pizza. And which one's the best.
As being mixed between four cheese.
No, but which type, because one of them lives in New York, so they were obviously defending, you know, New York being the best one. Then, like, you had other types as well. It was just, oh, jeez.
Yeah,
They didn't end up in that argument. It was.
That's where you're wrong. Thin crust. Because less calories.
Pizza's just disgusting in the first place.
You can't say it because A, you cannot eat it.
I have tried it.
Fair enough.
Because, you know, because at school, we even made pizzas and were able to... Because, yeah, at school, we made pizzas and it was... Yeah, it was disgusting. So we had to eat them afterwards. And I couldn't get out of that. I really did not feel good after that. We had to because we had to write reports because it was food tech.
Well, you could have just said, I can't because of reasons.
We are talking about me in school. Fishing. Hey Pops, you want some fish? Ones we had to make in the first place.
Did they give you the ingredients to make them, or...?
Yeah.
Yeah, that explains a lot.
The teacher had gone to Waitrose to buy them, because this was before everything, you know, was done through, you know, company deliveries and whatnot. So it's not like my school had gone cheap on the ingredients.
I know, but still.
Right, which bit are you disappointed about? The fact they didn't go cheap on the ingredients or they used Waitrose for it?
It says a lot about your school, no offense.
Again, remember the era I was in the school. It wasn't all, you know, schools actually, you know, had a better food system. Because you could go in the cafeteria and pretty much get almost anything you want, for, you know, to a degree. They had, like, the menu of the day thing, but they had, you know, a proper day, you know, bit that was always there, you know, like, had a load of, like, they had sandwiches done up, they had, you could get sausage rolls there each day if you wanted. Various, like, bits of cake. It was like a proper food selection. Not like what schools became, where it's like, here's your slop each day.
I admit, the cafeteria in my secondary school was a lot better than other things.
That's what we're after.
Their brownies were pretty good.
Yeah, but the problem was, the big problem I was in a school with nearly 1,000 kids.
Oh, we all had 1,000 kids.
And bear in mind, this is a very old building, so the cafeteria area was not that big. and everyone had to funnel through it in 1 hour. There's a reason I always went to Greg's on the way home from school and not have lunch. Well, actually, a few reasons. But, yeah, that was one of them. Because I was, you know, because I was always with the naughty lot, it meant being let out late for lunch, which basically meant you had no time to go and get food, because by the time you get your food, you basically have to go to class again. And it was all cold at that point, if you wanted something hot. Such as... I understand from when Isabel went to the school, like, with the way everything had changed over the years, they had, in, you know, implemented staggered lunch times.
Yeah.
So, but yeah, apparently the food had really gone downhill at that point. Because literally, you were basically given, I think, here's your normal option, here's your vegetarian option, that's it. Yeah. Then it never looked good, apparently.
The owls look nice. I just... I think I was just starting, you know, the beginning spiral into...
As it all went downhill. The obsession of offering... No, I said normal. Your normal, you know, sort of meat-based thing, and then your vegetarian option. That's what I mean, Joe. Not saying vegetarian stuff is not normal, because it's, you know, people's choice there. It's just the way the food is. That there for a moment. Just do that for a minute. And let's go and see a Pokemon. Mistakes again.
Yeah, I'm not poisoned.
Are you walking through one of the swamps?
No, actually, surprisingly. There's just a random enemy that
kind of just helps. So, these trees have now vanished, and you get this little walkway.
Why do you look like a certain person?
Please tell me it's a friendly person.
At first they're friendly.
Oh great, patches. Of course there's gonna be patches! Have you found their equivalent of the Crestfallen?
Yes.
Of course, course, of course, we'd have those character types because, A, patches is just a reoccurring thing in FromSoft games for the most part, and Crestfallen is kind of synonymous with the Soulsborne stuff.
No, during the loading screen, there was a character that was insanely familiar. When I say insanely familiar, I mean, holy crap, I know you.
So as he sees dead people. Right. Let's do this. Time to go get ourselves a big, well, let's go catch the devil.
Woo! Satan! We're gonna see Satan! We're gonna see Satan! Why do you look like a building that's recognizable? Oh my god! What the bloody hell are you, mate? Be a bad idea.
One thing I don't like, I hate the puzzle in this place, because like, get to the end in under 30 rooms. Passing by the three pillar rooms.
I was quite proud of that. I managed to do that on first try, so...
Yeah, but here comes the big thing. If you, after you deal with Giratina, if you come back in the entire... leave the entire place, then come back in. If you get to Giratina's room in under certain thresholds, there'll be a rare item waiting for you. Yeah, and one of them is doing it in three rooms. So you have to get really good RNG to get three pillar, all three pillars back to back.
What the bloody hell is that?
Yes, done it. There's the third pillar room. And there is the devil.
Satan! 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 Satan!
You up front. You can resist some of its moves. You resist stuff.
I'm sorry, what?
It's not Pokemon number 666, that's what. Joe, just put. Issue some items for a second. Six arms, six legs, six arms, six spike. Well, it's close. I guess.
I'm guessing we can't swim. Yeah, that's probably not death ahead. Okay.
Do that. Actually, I'm going to move that leftovers. That on you. I'm going to save up. Face us, demon! I mean, Giratina doesn't really have arms. It's only... six legs, six spikes. Although, you can technically say it's got more than six spikes because it's got two sets of six. Got a load of spikes. Damn it, it's opened up with. It went first. Ha! You missed your big failure.
be called?
No, I'm talking to Giratina.
No, but you said my name though.
No, I didn't say Susie.
Well, you said the crazier, that's me.
Nah. Because I wouldn't call them arms, because, well, I think they're just more like it's part of its armour. Let's just do this. Make our team be able to take the thing on better. Paralyzed, and it's going to have basically no accuracy stat. It's got pressure, so. It did nothing to my Pokemon, it all it did was hurt itself. Right, there we go, that's accuracy minimal. Oh, and then it freaking has a move that never misses anyway. Of course. Let's just. Furious Rage! You're much better than Lame Rage. Cut your attack down so your physical moves aren't as damaging. Waterfall. That did. Okay. You're seeing flinched. Be careful when doing these super effective damage hits. Yeah, that's okay. Pain split. Damn it, you healed off of that. Crunch. Run out of aura spears eventually, yeah. Waterfall it again. I mean, yeah, it doesn't leave Aura Sphere as the only real threat it's got now because it won't miss with it, but the advantage here is Gyarados can tank those. And now we begin the worst part of this. Because, yeah. Two shakes on the first throw was actually pretty good. More than I was expecting. Two more than I was expecting. So, you know. Yeah, there was a little more. Ah, damn it, disappearing. The only thing I hate here right now. See, you can't throw balls at this thing. I'm doing that. I'm trying to think when the last time was I used the Master Ball. But then obviously like with the Timer Ball, you really need to be counting the number of turns. Because it's only once a certain... Because the power of the Timer Ball only goes up at certain thresholds of turns and... It's only after, I believe, 30 turns that it's really the timer ball is better than any other ball bar the master ball for catching Pokemon. Something like that. Like, yeah, I can't remember the... I have to actually read up the full timings on things. You know what? I'm gonna do that right now because I've got nothing better to do. Da-da. Generation 5 onwards. One plus turns times 1,229 over 4,096 divided by 4. You know what? The math formula makes no sense to me. A rhythm mechanic, but it's based on the, say, the number of turns. Here we go. Catch rate. Turn zero, it's just... I mean, it goes up a little bit each turn, but like the key thresholds is catch rate... It's catch rate one, obviously turn zero, goes up... So at 10 it becomes catch... Oh, right, and then they rejigged it in Gen 5 onwards. No, okay, yeah, so... I didn't realise they rejigged the catch rate for it in Gen 5, but they actually made it power up quicker in Gen 5. So I knew at turn 30 it hit 4 times catch rate. But yeah, since Gen 5 it's only been on turn 10. So, yeah. Okay. That's kind of interesting. So yeah, okay, it's not actually that bad anymore, having to wait out 30, only 10 turns than 30. You'll easily do that. So yeah, it's kind of the thing with some balls, that they have certain special rules. Yeah, quick ball has a catch rate of 5 times if you use it on the when you use it on turn 1. Otherwise, it's just a 1 times catch rate. So if you ever want to just lob a ball at the beginning, always, yeah, it is really always the timable. Okay, here's an old ball that I'm just seeing. Fast ball, what was that? Oh yeah, from earlier editions, fast. Yeah. Yeah, fastball has got a serious calculation because it's based on speed stats and whatnot. Difference in level of the Pokemon. Oh, jeez, that ball is Okay, I found the best Pokeball that's not the Master Ball. Yeah. The best ball that's not the Master Ball is the level ball. There are a few little caveats though. So the level ball was one of the apricorn balls from Gold, Silver, Crystal. And if your Pokemon is 4 times or greater higher level than the Pokemon you're trying to catch, it has an 8 times catch rate. But obviously, yeah, there's the problem. It only works up. It only works when you get a certain point. Oh, Jesus, healing itself. So what? Yeah, you basically need to be level 80 and catching a level 10 or below a Pokemon for this to work. Jeez. Yeah. If you need to catch low level Pokemon late game, that's how you do it.
No.
Susie sounds like she's having fun.
Yeah, a lot of fun. A lot of fun.
Oh, there goes a Pokemon. But yeah, it's kind of, yeah. I think it should just be the differences in general it works on. Doesn't matter if it's you higher or them higher. Just the greater the difference between you and them, the better. But 8 times catch rate, damn it. Why can't we have another Pokeball like that? Because it would just be OP. Giratina, come on, don't you want to be friends? We want you as a friend. Not to, you know, harm you much more than we already did. Yuck, that's a lot of health you recovered. You do know we... Well, no, I said it's, you have to be higher level than them, that's what I was saying, Joe. I said they need to, like, I wish it worked both ways, not just one way around. Hey, we caught Giratina while we were distracted. We got the devil. Because, yeah, if the Pokemon... Yeah. I'm not alright nicknaming you. Yeah, it's a pity, because that would be fun if they did that, but I think that's probably why they don't do it. Yay, that's Giratina done, so that's in there done. Just got one last thing we'll do before we call it. What I am going to do during the week is I'm going to go around the map with the super rod and catch any Pokemon that we fish up with the super rod. In addition, I will anyone with the super rod, I'll track down Cresselia and catch Cresselia. Think what else need doing between. Yeah, and I'll probably get some. I don't know if I'll get around to doing the evolution of the Pokemon we've got sitting waiting at the minute. Beyond a couple of them. Just go in here for the moment. We've already got Farfetch'd because they spawn in the underground. Everything I need to collect. Because all the way down here, Professor Oak, we get that item so we can evolve Porygon. Right. So I fly back to the home, because that'd be the best place to start. But yeah, so... like I say, I'll work my way through the map, all across, to get any Pokemon in the waters with the Super Rod. Obviously, I'll be keeping an eye on the Pokemon Mansion. For Pokemon that are spawning in the garden, I'm keeping an eye on the Great Marsh, so I can get the Pokemon there. So yeah. So then next week we can explore all up here. So I'm going to say once I'm done with everything up on this part of the map, I'm going to say that'll be it. I know there's still the temple here, but like the Ramius Park element is just going to be a pain because of getting the resources to actually do it, so yeah. But yeah, that's basically going to be the plan of how we're going to wrap this up, which will basically end it with the capture of Heatran. So yeah, we'll obviously still got bits over the weekend. Star Wars will be on Sunday again. Don't know quite what we're doing tomorrow, but then back Monday for Elden Ring. Yeah. All right, everyone. Night.
Night.